Bellbottom is a new Bollywood movie, and it says it's based on a true story. Sure, at the beginning it says it's not recreating the events, just merely inspired by them. But no, no. I hope it all happened just like this. The film takes place in 1984 and revolves around a hijacked airplane and the team of agents brought in to save the hostages. But they specifically want one man for the job. As they say, bring us the best of the best. What's his name? We just got a code name. Bellbottom. Complete with walking in all badass and in slow motion. Like James Bond, only with the best mustache in the country. He gets the job done. As his superior says, sometimes I want to fire him, but unfortunately, he's bloody brilliant. With this setup, I was wondering how they were going to work in the musical number. And yes, they do. Not long after we're introduced to the character, it flashes back 5 years to his backstory and how this hostage crisis is personal to him. In the flashback, he says, I gotta get to my brother's wedding. Yes, this is where the musical number will happen. He's with his wife at the wedding, and his mom goes, get up on stage and sing! It shows us through musical montage he and his wife's romance. And when they're slow motion swinging on a tree swing, embracing outside of a train, at a drive-in watching a movie of this very montage, and making love on a mattress in the middle of a body of water, I had to remind myself, this is a film about a hostage crisis on an airline. Again, I hope all of this really happened. It goes back to being a thriller not long after, when he loses someone close during another hostage situation and is approached to join the secretive RAW organization. He does it all action thrillery-like, too. He picks up the phone and says, game on. I do appreciate that the movie is very much character-based. About 70% has more to do with his backstory than it does the airliner, and Akshay Kumar is very likable in the film. We go through his training and see him assembling his team, where at one point in the middle of the film, it kind of becomes a Bollywood version of Spielberg's Munich. The musical score is catchy with a lot of synth work and sort of a jazzy sound-alike of the Godfather theme. There's some familiar music stings too, like when the lead does something cool and it does the ban-a-dow, and there's even a couple of dun-dun-duns. I will say, though, while there's a lot to like, the movie does lag quite a bit in the middle act. You'll have scenes of them discussing plans, followed by another scene of them discussing plans. Now they're in an airport hangar, again discussing plans. And since Bellbottom looks the same in the present as he does in the flashbacks, sometimes I was confused as to where we were in the timeline. When it does get to the third act, though, there is some good suspense between the double crosses, oh, and the fact that a sandstorm happens during a rescue attempt. I particularly like one part where he opens a villain's throat to catch sand in his mouth. The movie is way more of a suspense thriller than an all-out action film. There's not any point where someone drives a motorcycle into a helicopter and then punches a tank. But it does work more often than it doesn't. I'll give the movie a B. It's 30 minutes too long and could easily be tightened, but it's worth a watch. Thanks for watching, everyone. We'll have a Midnight Screenings review coming up for Candyman. Plus, I'll finally be getting around to seeing The Green Knight. See you next time.